0-for-3 could really use this for his confidence. Mason Drellenbach goes the opposite way. Deep, 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 back on the wall. That is over the fence for a home run. Drellenbach goes opposite way here in the Queen City for the first run of 2019 for the Badlands Big Sticks. New pitcher for the Big Sticks, Michael Calia Jr. from Lower Columbia Community College, hails from Kent, Washington. 2-2 count. Here's the pitch. Nice off-speed pitch, and he got Alexander swinging. Now a shot opposite field in the gap to right center for a double, a stand-up double, Bentoma. Well, the kid from Jackson, Mississippi throws the leather for Alcorn State, Mr. Joe Smith. Swing and a miss. Got him. Huge strikeout for Joe Smith against A.J. Domino. We go to the bottom of the third inning, and Carson Backer, a North Dakota product, will swing the bat first for the Sticks. Backer, the DH, a right-handed hitter, and he faces Landon Cody on the mound, also a right-hander. Backer now, floater out to left field. That's going to drop in for a base hit just down the chalk at third. So the count is 1-2, not 2-1, with two down and Modeste at first base. Swing and a miss. Nice job by Nick Flesher to come back. And Bullifin retired on strikes, and that is strikeout number 5 for Nick Flesher. His command has been stellar tonight. Now a ground ball to short. What a play by the shortstop, Anthony Garrett. He said, Robbie Merced, the shortstop for the Whiskey Jacks, if you can make a play like that, I can as well. This time he's moving towards second, slid after the ball, and then plants and throws to get a speedy Jared Hazeldean. Brock Rountree on the bump now. Kid out of Adel, Georgia, pitches for Albany State. Two balls, two strikes, two outs, two on. Cedric Girard, last hope for the move at the plate. Swung on and missed. And Brock Rountree with three strikeouts in the top of the ninth inning, and the Big Sticks win it 15-8. Ryan Gross now comes to the plate as he slaps this one to left field, and it off the base of the left field fence just over the head of Brett Ritchie. I thought Ritchie had that one in his glove, but I think Gross caught him off guard with that line drive to left field, and that's just what the doctor ordered for Ryan Gross. It's the aforementioned Jack Zelaski, one of two Sacramento State players. There's a swing and a miss, and Martin goes down to strike for the second time tonight. Third in a row is Jack Zelaski. Time here in Dickinson winding down, and he mows down the side. One down, bottom of the fourth. Ground ball by Schwellenbach. A one hop over to third base coach Johnny Eaton as he catches it and tosses over to the Big Sticks dugout. Well done, Coach Eaton. Ground ball, Palomero in the gap between short and third base hit. A leadoff single in the bottom of the second for Anthony Palomero. Palomero, like Walstead, joined the team yesterday. They basically got out of their cars, grabbed a uniform, and stepped onto the field, and they played short and second, and they're doing it again tonight. As Walstead takes this pitch, the first one, and it's gone! Ryan Walstead! Stop it already! Over the right field wall, a two-run shot. The Big Sticks are in front, 6-3. New pitcher for the Badlands Big Sticks, number 21, Matthew Burley, out of Spokane, Washington, throws the leather for Spokane Falls Community College. Leadoff man, top of the ninth. Swing and a miss. Three straight strikes delivered by Matthew Burley. And Burley got to feel good as the ball thrown around the horn. Humphrey, hard hit ball, that's going to drop in the gap in right center, and the Big Sticks are back in the hit column in the bottom of the seventh inning. Well done, Jared Humphrey. Two more runs scored, the Big Sticks are back in front by 5. 0-2 the count now. Runners going, swung on and missed. And Hulse goes down swinging, and just in 2 1/3 innings of work, Joel Torres had 5 strikeouts. Awesome job by Joel Torres here tonight. Mitch Dean will lead off for the Badlands Big Sticks, playing third base, and the first pitch offered to Mitch Dean, home run! I took my eye off the ball momentarily, and Mitch Dean made me pay for it. Hand injury? Are you kidding me, Mitch? Harris from the stretch now ahead of the count, 1-2, and Rennell goes after that one with a token sick the bat out type thing, and it didn't work very well, and another strikeout for Joseph Harris. He's got a six-pack tonight. Six strikeouts now for Joseph Harris, and that brings the nine-hitter Dylan Ditzenberger to the plate. A hit tonight to his credit. He's got a single and a run scored with a couple of ducks on the pond. One down, bottom of the seventh. Big Sticks lead by 4-7-3. Line drive, center field. That's going to drop in for a base hit. And that scores Garrett Dupuy from second. Second single of the night for Ditzenberger. He's 2-for-4 on the evening. Hustling over there, a diving catch. What a catch by Michael Furman! Highlight reel material on the first fly ball of the ball game. So Michael Furman catches the fly ball of Jason Roberson as I come back to planet Earth. Mapston working straight away in a normal windup, and Olsen slaps this one out to left field. In the gap, base hit, Braden Olsen. Olsen's on his horse with a stand-up double. Well, Gabe Lazarga returns to the mound for his second inning of work for the Big Sticks pitching staff. Again, Gabe retired 3-up, 3-down for the Saberdogs last inning. Looking to duplicate that here. He's been with the Big Sticks 2 years in front of a home crowd. First ever home playoff game, and got a chance to honor him as well.
He was really good tonight. So, I mean, the kid works his tail off, and, you know, he's going to be successful whatever he does.
Nobody out. Here's a floater out to center field. It's going to bounce in for a base hit. And Garrett Dupuy is the hit machine tonight as he continues to churn out the singles. Three singles for Garrett Dupuy tonight. That one's an RBI as Van Cleef comes across the plate. And the Big Sticks now lead 8-6. And the 1-2 pitch from Brian Nereller, outside corner, called strike three. And Brian closes the door on the Fremont move. The Big Sticks get a two-game sweep, and they improve to 19-5. Big Sticks, best record in the Expedition League. Parkhurst back to work. Knowles, high, towering fly ball center field. Is that out of here? It is, and it's a grand slam, Gabe Knowles. And the Big Sticks lead by 10, 12-2. Holy buckets! Nick Jennings will now pitch for the Big Sticks. Nick, of course, has been with the Big Sticks 2 years, and he's been staying with the host family, the Brierleys, who lost the father of the family here last weekend in an accident. And so Jennings out on the mound, pitching with a heavy heart. That one swung on and missed. And what a way for Nick Jennings to end it with back-to-back strikeouts. You could see his elation as he pointed to the sky. So 0-1 now to Connor Van Cleef. Bases loaded, nobody out. Big Sticks already up 12-2. Van Cleef hits this shot. It's going to get in the gap in left center, and that's going to be a double for Connor Van Cleef. And three runs will score, and Van Cleef continues to tear up the Expedition League with RBIs. There's a swing and a miss, and it's strikeout number 11 for Michael Redick, and he's absolutely throwing darts. Wow! So strikeout number 11 ends the top of the fifth inning. You've got two base runners, and you've had one cross the plate. All that since the second out. Sousa Palui now turns on a pitch and drives it deep into the gap in right center, and that is gone! A home run, Kaimana Sousa Palui! Oh, my! Exclamation point on the end of the sentence. So we're going to do the payoff pitch one more time. Swung on and missed. Nicely done, Matthew Meskin. Meskin hadn't struck out a batter since the fourth inning. He's got K number 7 on the night as he retires Luke White. Not an easy task. Here's the 2-1 now from Odom to Sanders. And Sanders belts this one out to center field. And that is gone. A home run, Nate Sanders. Again, the best nine-hitter in the Expedition League, bar none. Batted clean up the last two nights with Van Cleef at a wedding, and Nate Sanders said, welcome back, Connor. I like the nine spot better, and he belts one over the fence in right center. This could be a mowing down inning for Malik Barrington as he tries to strike out the side. Here's the 0-2 now. Swing and a miss, and he does it. Nicely done, Malik Barrington. 8th strikeout of the night. We're only in the fourth inning, ladies and gentlemen. Here's a swing and a miss. Nice pitch, Tyler Chipman, to retire Aaron Johnson. You talk about a kid that just doesn't quit. Tyler Chipman just got his ninth strikeout, and he looked like he was tiring out and was going to have to depend on his defense to get the out, but Chip gets his ninth strikeout of the evening. 3-1 now to Bryson Ford. Two down, top of the ninth. Fly ball, deep left field. Is it out of here? It is! A two-run homer! And the Big Sticks lead 6-1. Ford had one hit last night, was not happy with his performance. He comes out tonight and has been lights out with the bat. Pair of singles, a triple, and now a two-run homer. New pitcher in for the Badlands Big Stick, 6'5", Court Dietrich. Runner on first. Dietrich needs to close the deal here. Maybe twist a double play. Coach Hayden Pugh out on the mound. A very quick visit. I'm sure just encouragement of the troops to say, guys, let's get it done. A 1-0 now for Rathbone. Here's a ground ball. Hit the second. Ford tosses to Furman. Furman twists it over, and the Big Sticks win on a double play! The Big Sticks are champions of the Expedition League! Their defense comes up big at the end after four errors in the ballgame. They twist a double play, and the Big Sticks hang on for a 6-5 win! Pioneers won the first half of the season in the Clark. They won the second half of the season in the Clark. The Big Sticks won the first half in the Lewis. They won the second half in the Lewis. And just a few games separated these two teams for the best record overall. And that's why Western Nebraska was the home team for this playoff series and why they started the series in Dickinson on Friday night. Big Sticks lost 9-1. Looked like doom and gloom. And the Big Sticks came back and impressed everybody, including myself, with a win last night. 7-2, setting the table for the third and final game of the series. And this one goes down to the wire. And the boys from Dickinson, North Dakota, get the win. 6-5, league champions for 2019. Dave Ouellette, the owner, Jason Watson, general manager, Hayden Pugh, the head coach, Johnny Eaton, the assistant. Dakota Community Bank and Trust scoreboard reads one final time. Badlands Big Sticks 6, Western Nebraska Pioneers 5, and go Big Sticks. Good night.